Everybody, so in this video we're going over the render cache and how it's taking up all of the memory on your computer. So what should you do about that? The first thing you should do is to delete your render cache, and we're going to go over that. So let's see here, you come into DaVinci Resolve. Up here at the top we're going to come over to playback. So there we go. All right, now I'm zoomed in so you can see this a little bit better. And then I'm going to come over here to playback, and I'm going to click on playback. And we're going to come right on down here to where you can see delete render cache, and there's manage cache data. So let's click on that. It might say cloud, network, whatever you have that clicked on. So on your local, we'll have certain ones, and then what I'm just going to select is all. Okay, so now right here where it says render cache, we're going to click on that, and we're going to click on it a second time if necessary. We'll scroll all the way to the top. Now you can see that in my last video, I have 576 gigabytes just for the render cache. I actually had more before I did this video. I had like 1.6 terabytes just in render cache on 4 different videos. So what that happened was it was filling up my edit SSD that I have, so I just need to clear it out. It's really simple to do. Make sure you do this after every video that you make, okay? So we're gonna click here where that is. I'm not going to do that because I'm still working with this one and this Star Wars fan film. This one was one of Casey Ferris's that I was working on. And let's see, this one. I don't need any of that cache, so I'm just going to click here, clear cache. Clearing out all that cache is really going to free everything up on my hard drive, make everything run much smoother. Speaking of which, if you are having everything caching directly onto your computer, it's really going to fill that up and it's going to cause you a lot of problems. So I highly recommend you get yourself at least a 2 terabyte SSD that you're editing, if you're editing a lot, that is. So I am using the Samsung 980 Pro. It's extremely fast. It's 2 terabytes and everything runs really smooth with that. So I just want to take a moment to introduce myself. If we haven't met already, my name is Chad. I make DaVinci Resolve tutorials and I create systems and processes which will help you streamline your workflow so you can focus more on your business. I truly enjoy helping other people succeed, and I'm quite passionate working with DaVinci Resolve and creating businesses. As I've created several businesses myself and know what the struggles are, I am here to help you out. So any questions that you have, please feel free to write anything down in the comment section and I will get back to you as soon as I can. If any of this information is being helpful to you in this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Truly help me out and build this channel. Thank you very much. Okay, so now let's transition this back so it's a little bit smaller. I'm gonna teach you a little bit about why you're getting such huge files. So I wasn't getting these size files until I started with the DaVinci Resolve 19. That's because when that was installed, my settings got changed. So let's go take a look at those settings. So right here in the bottom right corner, we're gonna click on this. Now that we've clicked on that, our project settings comes up. So what we're going to do is right here under master settings, we're going to scroll down here. And here you can see we have optimized media and render cache. So my proxy media resolution, I just leave set to automatically. Proxy media, you can adjust this to whatever you're going to use here if you want. So under optimized media format, this is at ProRes 422 HQ. These are gonna be pretty big files. So we can easily change that. We can come down here, and as you see, we have this DNxHRHQ. There's the SQ and the LB. If you are on a really old computer, then you can use maybe the SQ or LB. It's definitely gonna help your slower computer run much better. I'm using a Mac Studio with an M2 Max, so I can run something much higher. I'm going to use this as HQ, and I'm going to do the same thing for my render cache format. And if needed, I can also do the same thing with that just to get everything matching. And down here to the bottom right, I can click save. But before doing that, we can come up here to these three little dots and we can click on that. And you can see here, this has default preset. If you want this to be the default preset so that every time you open this project in from the project manager, you can just come over here and you can update preset. So just click that and you can update it, and all of the settings you have here will automatically be saved. Another thing you can do is you can export this preset, or, you know, so that way you can save this and then you can just open up if you are specifically editing something that you need just this for. Once you are finished getting all of your settings done, just come down here and click save. From there, you are just going to save so much space on your cache. I was a little too slow in resizing this. However, once I clicked save, all of this had to cache again. So let's just go see what that will show here. So remember, we're going to come under here. It's playback. We're clicking on that. And we come down to delete render cache. Click on manage cache data. And then here we have everything that we're doing. So right here, I have 895.7 megabytes of cache data for this specific video set. So now that is how you save all the space on your computer or your hard drive, simply by clearing out your cache and getting the proper settings before you even start to render anything out. I really hope this information has been extremely helpful to you. And if you're still looking for help with other things, according to your watch habits and the YouTube algorithm, they believe that this video over here is the best one for you to watch next. I look forward to see you in the next one. Thanks.